Assalamu alaikum. Hello to everyone. Welcome to the channel, The Physics Gurus. And I am Rizwan Halil. Today, I will explain the MCQs part of O-level IGCSE physics. And the topic which I will explain is related with the transfer of thermal energy. Already, I have explained the MCQs on the method of transfer of thermal energy via conduction. Today I will explain the second method of transfer of thermal energy, that is convection. Convection actually took place in fluids. Fluids mean air and liquid. So convection took place in fluids, and it can be air or it can be liquid. In convection, molecules actually move from one place to another place by carrying heat. Now, there are two parts of the convection. Number one, what happens when heating is being done, and what happens when cooling is being done. Whenever heating is being done, the fluid expands, becomes less dense, lighter, and that particular fluid rises up to produce convection current. What happens in cooling? Fluid becomes more dense, or its density becomes more heavier and sinks down by producing convection currents. So let's move towards the MCQs related with these concepts. Okay, we have done the conduction part. Now we will start the convection part of the MCQs. There is one suggestion for all of you, that before attempting these MCQs, always please kindly go through the topic in details so that you might have the strong grip on the concepts, then you can easily solve these MCQs. So we have done the conduction part. Now we will solve the MCQs on the convection part of the transfer of heat, or you might say transfer of thermal energy from one place to another place. So let's start the MCQ related with convection. So convection basically is related with density changes, and it happens in liquids and in air, and molecules actually moves from one place to another place. So density changes. First MCQ is straightway related with the density changes keyword. So density changes is responsible for which method of transfer of heat? Conduction, no. Free electrons are there. Radiation space is required. This is not possible. So which option is correct answer? Option B is the correct answer. That is convection only. MCQ number two. A teacher has a large tank of the water in which he wants to set up the convection current. And convection currents always took place the point from where the liquid or air is being heated or it's being cooled down. So which of the following arrangement would do this? Cooling at X. Since point X is at the bottom, so when it is being cooled down, it has to be moved in the downward direction, but it is already stuck with the bottom, so no convection current can be produced. Okay. Heating at Y. Since if point Y is being heated, then it will move, or molecules at the point Y will move in the upward direction, since already point Y was at the top of the surface, so no convection currents are being produced. So option C is also not possible. Heating at Z, again, when molecules at point Z are being heated, then they are supposed to be moved in the upward direction, but already they are at the top of the liquid surface, so no convection currents took place. But when we will consider the option B, when we will consider the option B, cooling at Y, now we will see what will happen. When a fluid or air is being cooled, it becomes more dense, heavier, and sinks down. So here, in this way, convection currents might be produced when particles are being cooled at point Y. So which option is now correct option? Option B. Let's move towards another MCQ. More or less, this MCQ is exactly same as we have solved over here, except the difference of molecules are being represented here in the dotted line, and here they have shaded the liquid. So the same MCQ more or less, cooling at X, not possible. Cooling at Y, yes, the same MCQ is there. So cooling at Y will produce the convection current, and all other options are not possible. So which option is correct? Option B is the correct answer. Excuse me. Next. Okay, this MCQ, the diagram shows a room seen from the above. It's cold outside from the room. The room is heated by a small fire in the fireplace. Where is the most heat lost by convection? Now, there are four options. Carpet, since it is not possible because carpet is being laid down with the floor, and in convection, it always moves in the upward direction. So carpet is not possible. Then solid wall, definitely in solid heat is being transferred the process of conduction. So it is also not possible. And now we are being left with the two options, chimney and glass windows. Have you ever observed that whenever we want to keep the homes in winter to make them hot, then what we will do? We will place some sort of stove or some sort of coals, and those stove or coals are being placed a place which is called as chimney. So waste gases are very dangerous. So these waste gases are very quickly moves in the upward direction. Why? Through the chimney, because they becomes lighter, less dense, and rises up. So in as compared to the glass window, they will move quickly from the chimney. So which option is correct? Option B. Glass window is there, since glass is the solid material, so it is not possible that most of the heat is being wasted through the glass as well. A double glazed window has two sheets of glass separated by a layer of air. Thermal energy is conducted and convected. So both processes are there through the layer of air. The amount of conduction and convection varies with the thickness of layer of air. It means that thickness of layer of air varies from time to time, as shown in the graph. So here, thickness of the layer of air in centimeter, and thermal energy transferred through a double glass window. Which thickness of air produces the smallest transferred energy and why? So now you can see that there are four options given in this MCQ. Now, this graph, we can see that this is the curve produced due to the conduction, then this is the curve produced due to the convection. And the point where these two curves intersect belongs to 1 centimeter. So which option is the correct? 1 centimeter, because total thermal energy transfer is least because it is at the minimum level. Here the value of energy is given. Suppose this was 0, this will be 20, this will be 30, this will be 40. So at 1 centimeter, the energy transfer of due to the thickness of layer is the minimum. So option B is the correct answer. Now proceed towards the next MCQ. It is related with the cooling process. And what happens in cooling? Density increases, particle becomes heavy and sinks. So what happens to the density of the air and its position inside the refrigerator? Definitely density increases because it is the cooling process. So option A and option B are being omitted. So now we will consider only option C and option D. And already we have studied that. What happens in cooling? Molecules sinks down due to their higher densities or heavy density. So which option stays at the bottom is now being omitted. So which option is the correct answer now? Option C is the correct answer. An electrical heater placed on the beaker of a cold oil as shown in figure. The heater is switched on. It means now heater will produce heat and oil is going to be heat up. So what happens to the liquid at point X? So it is almost at the mid of the beaker. So whenever a liquid is being heated in convection process, what happens? Its density becomes less or more? Yes, its density becomes less. So these two options are being omitted. And now we are being left with the option A and option B. And whenever they are being having less density, they always rises up. So which option is now correct? So falls over here will be the wrong. Then option B will be the correct, less dense and rises up. So but you have observed that if you have the clear concept of the topic, then you can easily attempt the MCQs. The next MCQ is there. Again, it is related with the cooling unit. So what happens in the cooling unit? Density increases and particles sinks down. Okay. When the refrigerator is switched on, first switched on, what happens to the air near the cooling unit? Okay. Increases, density increases, and density increases. So these two options are being opted out. And now we have to select the option B or option D. It is not possible that when particular part is being cooled down, then they become smaller. It is not possible. When they are being heated or they are being cooled down, size of the molecules never ever supposed to be changed. So option B is not a suitable option. Then which option is being left? Option D. Molecules move closer together because now their densities are being higher. So they are heavier. So they will move now closer to each other. So it is not possible that molecules are going to be smaller or larger. The next MCQ, in which state of matter does the convection occur? And convection always occurs in fluids, that is liquid and gases. So solid, solid and solid. So these options are being opted out and we are being left with the option B, gases and liquids only. Now move to the next MCQ, and that is most probably the last MCQ of this topic. The diagram shows the glass tube filled with the water and suspended above the bench. The water is free to circulate around the tube. Okay, Jim. At point P, there is a convection current moving downwards in downward directions at point P. Convection current in moving downward direction. At which point is the tube heated to cause this convection current? So There are four options given: A, B, C, D. So if we are going to heat up at point B, so point B is already at the top, so it is not possible that molecules are supposed to be moving in upward direction. Then option C, again, if we are going to heat up, molecules will move in upward direction. And then at option D, if we are going to suppose we are going to heat up at point D, definitely molecules will move in upward direction. But what is given? Direction of convection current is from top to bottom. And when we are going to heat up the molecules from point A, now you can see when we will heat up this, then convection currents will produce in this way. So now it matches with this option. So which option is the correct option? Option A is the correct answer. So I hope that now it will be very easy for you people to solve the MCQs related with the topic convection. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum.